feel like you're being pulled in a thousand directions? Let's fix that. Download your free rebalancing toolkit and learn how to design an optimized week that lets you feel like you have it all. Get the goods at brilliantbalance.net/haveitall.
I'm Cherylanne Skolnicki, and this is Brilliant Balance, the show for working women who are ready to shine. Each week, I bring you ideas, inspiration, and insight on balance, business, and getting it all done gracefully. You ready? Let's be brilliant. This is episode 99 of the Brilliant Balance podcast. Hey, everybody, welcome back. I have to tell you, this month is so full around Brilliant Balance headquarters. It's so exciting. We have the 30-day energy challenge underway again. And I just love leading this experience for the women who are a part of it. It is such a blast. It feels very likely that we will do this again since it's going so well this time. So stay tuned if you missed it and are hoping that you get another shot. We are planning behind the scenes for when another one of these might happen, because it's just so fun to watch women feel fully awake and alive again with some of the shifts that we're able to teach. So love seeing that happening. I'm having a blast with them. And I love watching our office, you know, rise up to support these women. All of the women on the Brilliant Balance team are playing right along, right? We're doing all the behaviors, we're engaged. And so there's this bustle of energy in our office. And it's such a moment sometimes, because I can remember when that environment was just a pipe dream. You know, when I just started this business 10 years ago, and it was just me sitting in my kitchen with my computer, and I was pregnant with my youngest daughter, and it just felt like this kind of environment was so far away. You know, this vision where we had a team and we were working towards something together. So it's just so exciting when you watch a vision like that really take shape and become reality. And it certainly didn't happen overnight. You know, in fact, the results were anything but immediate. This is a very long and twisting path to get to where we are today. And when you're on that long and twisting path, it can feel like you're never going to get there. It's so frustrating when you really, really, really want something and it's just not happening. And that, in fact, is exactly what today's episode is all about, is why you aren't getting the results that you want. And I think there's a framework that we can look at here. It's certainly been very helpful to me during those periods of frustration as the business was growing, or honestly, as I was pursuing other goals, personal or professional. I didn't learn this framework right away. You know, I mean, it's something that I think when I say it, there's nothing here that's rocket science, but it's just not something we always think about. And so that lack of awareness or our unconsciousness about this pattern can really cause frustration. And I think when we bring this into the forefront of our minds, it can give us some hope about where we're headed, or give us the opportunity to course correct. Either one would be a good outcome. So what we're talking about today is why you aren't getting the results that you want, right? And the answer is probably in this framework that I'm going to share. And we're going to see if this provides some insight for you as we go here. Okay. So the first point I want to reinforce is results, if you think about it, are not magic, right? Results are driven by behaviors. In fact, they're driven by, in almost all cases, a very particular and very small set of behaviors that lead directly to the result or the outcome that we want. The magic is in discerning what are those behaviors, right? What are the critical few actions that are going to deliver the results that we want? So if we look at a couple of examples here, I picked three to share. One is, if you think about a realtor, somebody whose business is, you know, listing and selling homes, The lead behavior, the critical activity that that realtor has to do if she is going to be successful is prospecting calls. And that has been proven over and over and over again. In fact, that's probably true for virtually all sales-related careers, but we'll use real estate as an example. If you want to be a successful real estate agent, the number one behavior that predictably leads to results is prospecting calls. And if you are consistent about making those prospecting calls, eventually the law of averages plays out, right? It's a numbers game. So the more calls you make, the more opportunities you have for one of those calls to turn into a hot prospect, right? Somebody who's ready to list or buy right now. And then you were the person who made the call, so you have the opportunity to convert. So that's an example in a business where the behavior for a realtor is making those prospecting calls. Let's look at another example. Let's say that what you want to do is lose 10 pounds, or you want to lose 20 pounds, or you want to lose 100 pounds, right? You want to lose some weight. The absolutely critical behavior, could argue, is eating fewer calories than you burn. Right? If you consistently consume fewer calories than you need, you are going to lose weight. It's scientific, right? Now, there's some nuance to this, and you could speed up the rate or slow down the rate based on some choices that you make, and that's not what we're here to get into today. It's like there is a particular behavior. Putting foods in your mouth that have fewer calories than you burn in a day, right? That's it. That is the one behavior you have to get right, and you can predictably lose weight. Third example, if you want to have a thriving marriage, the one behavior, this one may be less obvious, that has been proven to absolutely predictably lead to a thriving marriage is quality time alone together. Quality time alone together, time that you're focused on each other, you're not focused on problems, and you're not focused on work. Right? It's not like, oh, we're alone together, but we're paying bills or we're working on the budget or we're trying to figure out, you know, some complex equation together. It's time alone together where you're really enjoying each other's presence. That one activity done with consistency predictably leads to a healthier marriage. Okay? So in any of these cases, and we could go on, and you probably have examples of your own, the result that you want is driven by a particular behavior being done repeatedly, right, and with excellence. So if you're not getting the result that you want, it's possible that you're not actually doing the behavior that leads to the results. Well, how would you know? How would you know? That leads to the second point, which is in this framework, the behaviors we track are the behaviors that we sustain. Okay. We often don't track our behaviors. We just don't. And so the realtor doesn't track how many prospecting calls get made, or we don't actually track the calories we're consuming, or we don't actually track how much time we're spending with our partner in that quality interaction, to use all the examples I just shared. So when we don't track our behaviors, we don't actually know. So we say things like, I don't know why I'm not losing weight. I eat really healthy, right? I eat healthy foods, or I make prospect calls, okay? But if it's not measured, if we don't have the rigor in the tracking, then we don't actually have the data we need to course correct, okay? So we get a little bit of a halo effect on our behavior. We think we're better than we are. We say, I know I've done that, right? I know we're spending quality time together. I know I'm making those calls. But if we're not really measuring it, it's really easy to overestimate how well we're doing with the behaviors, okay? So in general, what you may find if you don't have the results you want is that you're not tracking your behaviors. And as a result, you're overestimating your effort, the quality of your effort, okay? So those are the first two places you can look if you're not getting the results you want. And this applies to absolutely any area of your life, anything, where you are trying to get a certain result. First of all, have you dialed in what the behavior is that leads to results? And second, are you measuring it in a way that you can make a course correction where necessary? Okay, ladies, who's ready for 2 days of big ideas and fun experiences with a group of extraordinary women? We've put together a high-energy venue and a girlfriend getaway vibe just for you. If that sounds like your idea of a good time, then please join me at our next Brilliant Balance Live. It's in Cincinnati on September 26th and 27th, 2019. And tickets are on sale now at CherylanneSkolnicki.com/live. Come learn how to chase your biggest professional dreams, raise a thriving family, and still fiercely protect breathing room just for yourself. I'm going to help you find a new rhythm for getting things done, one that keeps you focused, energized, and fully engaged. Your life, it's about to get a major upgrade. Get your tickets today. The link is in the show notes. So that's the first two pieces of the framework. The third thing, if both of those are great, if you assess there and you're like, I know what the behavior is and I am tracking it and baby, I am on it, right? I am doing this perfectly. The third thing that could be in the way is you may have forgotten about what I call the results lag, okay? This is the gap between cause and effect. And this really is the piece that can catch you by surprise and take the wind right out of your sails. Because what happens when we forget about the results lag is we give up before those results kick in. Okay, so this is where you get statements like, I don't get it. This scale has not moved at all, and I have eaten a salad every blessed day this week, right? I was so good, 7 days of salads, and this scale has not moved at all. Or it's where you hear that same realtor say, I have made 30 prospect calls and I still don't have a listing out of it. Or I worked out every day for the last 2 weeks and I still don't see visible abs, so this must not be working, right? All of these things, and we know we've all said them. I've said them, you've said them. This is so typical. We want that immediate gratification. We are now committed to this result. We are all in. We want it. We've adjusted our behaviors. We've tracked it. Where are our results? Well, this results lag is wicked. It is often 90 days or longer between cause and effect. Okay? Cause and effect are separated, often by at least those 90 days, sometimes honestly by years. But 90 days is pretty predictable. So if you haven't been consistently engaged in the behavior and tracking it and seeing that your tracking says, yep, you are consistently engaged in this behavior, if it hasn't been 90 days yet, you really haven't earned the right to give up. But we often do. Okay, so that is the third reason why we often say, I don't know why I'm not getting results. It's like we haven't been consistent enough for long enough to have that results lag elapse and start to actually feel the results. And guess what? By the time the results kick in, we have what I call effort amnesia. We have forgotten the effort that we've been putting in. So, you know, we're diligently doing all these things, kind of unconsciously. And finally, we start to see results and we think, I don't even know what happened. And we start assessing the immediate past. So think about a business, like a realtor has a record month and she's like, wow, look at all, this was the best month I've ever had. What did I do this month? And she starts looking at her behaviors for this month. Well, guess what? That's not what drove that success. That success was driven by work that she did months ago. Right? That's where the results are coming from. So when we try to diagnose success or failure, we're often looking at this kind of recency effect. And that's not really where the answers are. The answers are further removed from the results that we're feeling right now. Okay? I'll tell you the other thing that's a little unsettling is this works in the other direction too. And that's how we often undo our good work before we even know what happened. So let's go with weight loss. We've lost the weight. right? We did the work, we were diligent, and 20 pounds comes off. We're fitting into all our clothes. We're like delighted with how we feel. So we think, well, what will a few fries hurt? You know, I'm in a great place. Or why not have the cake? Or why do I need to keep weighing myself, right? I've got this now. So we get a little cocky that our results are going to be sustained forever. And then it gets reinforced because you have the fries and you have the cake and you don't weigh yourself maybe for a couple of weeks and you get on the scale and everything is fine, right? Nothing seems to have changed. But 90 days from now, if that behavior continues, it's going to creep back. So we often sabotage our results. We undo our good work once we've made progress because we feel like we're getting away with it. You know, our marriage is good. We're feeling great. We're feeling really connected. He's not going to mind if I start staying late at work again because we're in this big crunch and he'll understand, right? Or the realtor's docket is full, so she relaxes and she stops making calls. And then 90 days later, there's that gap in the forecast because that cause and effect are separated. And we forget that all the things we did that led to the results we're seeing today, we forget about them, okay? So these points are designed here to help you when you are in that frustration cycle, when you are banging your head against the wall wondering, why is this not working? Why am I doing all the things that everybody says work? You know, I'm following the formula. This worked for all my friends, or it worked for all my fellow business owners. And why am I not seeing results? The questions I want you to ask yourself are, do you know the behavior that predictably leads to the result you want? Are you sure? You know, have you vetted it? Have you asked questions of people? Have you had that experience yourself before? Do you know the behavior? And then second, once you're sure you have the behavior and it's proven to lead to those results, are you tracking it? Are you really being honest with yourself and really being diligent about tracking that behavior? And then third, are you taking into account that gap between cause and effect? You know, are you accounting properly for that results lag that's normal? And if, this is a little caveat, if you're sliding backwards, have you looked at what may have started to change up to 90 days ago to get a clue? That framework should help you diagnose why you are not getting the results you want. And then here's the beauty of it. As soon as you've diagnosed it, no shame, right? Don't beat yourself up. All you need to do is restart that behavior and commit, right? Commit to staying consistent with that behavior. And then just be patient. Enjoy the ride, right? The results are coming. You know they're on the way. So you can get back on track with the behavior, get back on track with tracking it, and then you have confidence as every day goes by that you are closer and closer and closer to the result that you want. The only thing that can break this system is if you don't identify the correct behavior or if you lie to yourself about how consistent you are, right? And honestly, both of those can be problems. Both of them, we can think we know the behavior, but we're slightly off, and we are experts, some of us, at lying to ourselves about how rigorous we are, right, with adherence to these behaviors. So that's another episode. That's another story for another day. But for today, I want you to really spend some time thinking about where in your life are you not getting the result you want? And is it possible that you have misidentified the behavior or that you're just not consistently taking action against that behavior that's going to get you where you want to go? If you do that, I can't wait to hear from you with the results that start to fall in line, because it is everything. It really is a game changer in your ability to get results. I would not go and attack 10 things at once with this. I would pick the thing you want the most and really be serious about the rigor of that one behavior and the consistency. Okay. We can get overwhelmed really easily. So one thing at a time is exactly the way you want to go here. All right. This, you may have heard me say at the beginning, is episode 99, which means next week, drum roll, we are celebrating episode 100 of the Brilliant Balance podcast. And I'm going to tell you, I almost slid by this one, you know, like, all right, whatever. It's episode 100, we'll move on. But had a chat with my team and we decided it's important. And in fact, I am going to talk next week about what I've learned about honoring milestones, even as an adult, right? Even when you might think it's silly, why it is important to pause and honor those milestones in your life when they come. It's going to be a good one. If you liked this episode, if you learned something today that you found valuable, I would love it if you would share it with a friend. And we've learned the easiest way to do that is just get the link, copy it, and text it to a friend who you think could benefit from what we've shared. Tell them why you liked it, why you're sending it along, and then let them take it from there. We have really seen the podcast reach grow by you who are loyal listeners sharing it with the people that you love. So thank you so much for doing that. It means the world to me when we hear how the podcast is reaching women through current listeners. It's just the best. If you're social, you want to follow me on Instagram at @cskolnicki. We have a lot of fun in Instagram. I love that platform. Or you can join our Facebook group, which is called Brilliant Balance. Just search groups for Brilliant Balance and we will welcome you in. It's a party in there and we are all getting ready for episode 100. Okay, that is it for today, my friends. Till next time, let's be brilliant.
This is the PodcastFactory.com.